Good morning to everyone. I welcome you for IIBS IAS Academy, Current Affairs Channel, IIBS IAS News Bureau. And today we are going to discuss about The Hindu news articles dated on 18th August 2020. Here we are going to discuss about three, four different topics. And foremost topic is SC verdict on, that is Supreme Court verdict on competitive examinations like JEE. Neat. This particular judgment has been heard by the Supreme Court in the bench where Justice Arun Mishra was the chief panel member. This particular article had two different article, first one in page number 1 and another in page number 8. Let me first discuss why this particular case went inside Supreme Court. Petitioners, including students from 11 different states, filed a case in Supreme Court saying that conducting examination like JEE through online mode and NEET through offline mode in the centers across the country was utterly arbitrary and whimsical, and it is violating the fundamental rights of fundamental right of life of lakhs of people, and it is going to affect the students' life because this examination is being taken by lakhs and lakhs of students throughout the country. If the student gets affected by COVID-19, that they may be getting deprived from appearing in this examination like JEE NEET, which will going to violate the fundamental right Article 14, which is a part of Indian Constitution. And they have already stated one more thing. A prime institute like Institute of Chartered Accountant of India has already cancelled the examination, and they are remaining examinations of CBSE, ICSE and ISC, they have already cancelled the examination. Why this NEET and JEE should not be postponed? That was the case which has been filed in Supreme Court. While arguing for this, Solicitor General Tushar Mehta said that the exam must be on. We have taken all preventive mechanism and And he has already stated that the vaccine for COVID is going to come as soon as possible. It is on pipeline. So students need not to get afraid in terms of writing the examination, which will determine the career factor of the examination. And Supreme Court Judge Justice Arun Mishra has stated that the court is not going to stop hearing any case amid of COVID. Same way, the educational institution and their academic activity cannot be postponed or cancelled on the grounds of effect of COVID throughout the country. That is the judgment which is given by Supreme Court. And one more thing that I like to add in this particular point is UPSC is going to conduct the preliminary examination as pre-planned on October 4th for preliminary examination. So the aspirants who are already applied for the CA preliminary examination, you don't get scattered. Kindly prepare for the examination, because next year calendar has also been released by UPSC yesterday, that is August 17th. So keep on preparing for your UPSC prelims examination. Don't lose the concentration. Don't get deflected to any other speculations or rumors. And the next important article is, we are going to directly discuss about the editorial part which was there in the middle page. This editorial is indirectly reflecting two more articles in today's newspaper. And this editorial starts with a key title called Better Test. India should quickly adapt the rapid, inexpensive and sensitive saliva test. Yesterday we have discussed about the test which is called Saliva Direct, which is approved by US FDA, that is Food and FDA. And here, India is India should ready to take such kind of inexpensive and sensitive saliva test, which mean whatever be the test that we are doing in India, it is not having huge efficacy. That means the report which is being got from a rapid PCR or RT-PCR or normal PCR, polymerase chain reaction, that particular test which is being done by India is not showing better result. That means it is not showing more than 85% of accuracy. But yesterday we clearly saw in our article, saliva test is going to give the result accuracy in terms of 90%+. They are saying that they can able to give 94% of efficacy in such kind of test. Here, this particular article is saying huge data. First one, they are saying that on August 15th, we have crossed more than 6.5 months with COVID, novel coronavirus. And India, now it has been having a grim milestone of 50,000 death. Total death rate is 50,000. And here, and nearly the total case reported is 2.6 million, out which fresh cases in a day since October 2. More than the total death now has been accurately 51,045. What is doubling the shorter time taken for the death toll to be doubled? Here, to be frank, before 30 days, we had the death rate as 25,000. Within 30 days, we have reached 50,000, which means the death rate is keep on increasing. And there is one more speculation which is given by lot many political party as well as NGOs. They are saying that government is under-reporting the death rate, especially in case of some states like Gujarat, West Bengal and Telangana, because there the mortality rate is single digit or double digit. Some days they don't have even a single death case. Especially when you talk about Telangana on July 26, they don't have even a single death case. And in terms of Gujarat, they have never crossed the mark called 30, except only one day, which means the death which is happening outside healthcare system are not being recorded by the particular health ministry of those states. This was the initial part of this article. And in second part of the article, they are explaining that South Asian Asian countries, as per South Asian Asian countries report, death per million population has been very low in India, which means the death rate, the fatality rate is too low in India. Continuous dip is high rate being due to more cases. Now only the positive cases is keep on increasing, and there too all the cases are asymptomatic and which are detected due to increased rapid antigen test, not due to PCR test. And large cities, even with huge and developed organized healthcare infrastructure, they are struggling to stop down or cut short the positive cases which have been increasing in cities like Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Telangana. Especially, this is not the case only in the south, even the same case has been reflecting to the north also. And the big shortcoming of this rapid antigen test is that is showing the sensitivity rate is too low. And as per ICMR recommendation, more states should have very low rate of validation of negative test result case using molecular method, that is polymerase chain reaction test, PCR test. Now we got by the God grace and by the research of lot many scientists who are a part of World Science Forum, they had developed a saliva test by LA University, which is approved by FDA of US. If such kind of test is being available to India at free of cost, at a less cost, India can facilitate rapid adoption of test by state after local validation. This is the only solution to cut short the positive case and to reduce the fatality rate. Apart from that, Indian government through the Department of Science and Technology. Science and Technology Department, they are funding two different companies. First company is FastSense Diagnostics and second company is Module Innovation. They had funded these two companies to develop antibody kit which can able to detect and which can able to also use as rapid PCR test to approach this particular test. Thus, MI, that is Module Innovation, Pune-based healthcare startup, is working on it, and they have already produced a new component called U-Sense, which is used as a point of care diagnostics kit that can detect urinary tract infection within 50 minutes. By using the same technology, they are going to develop a new system which can able to detect corona within 10 to 15 minutes. This is the first one. Second one, one more organization called FastSense Diagnostics, they are also working on it. They are also planning to find rapid RT-PCR kit which can able to detect this COVID in shorter duration. And here, this FastSense is planning to find a rapid detection method which can able to detect 50 sample, which 50 samples can be tested within an hour. That was the plan which is been working by FastSense health startup company. Apart from that, we had more than 4 to 5 different vendors or companies which are authorized by US FDA, that is Food and Drug Administration of US. There are only 3 companies which have been approved to sell this rapid antigen test in India. First one is SB Biosensor, second one is Vishad Diagnostics, and third one is MyLab Discovery Solution, which is a Pune based company. Only these 3 companies are presently working with rapid antigen test which is approved by US FDA agency, and they are developing this rapid antigen test for Indian community. Antigen test can able to detect the presence of the virus quicker than PCR. That's why we are using that particular antigen test, and this antigen test is showing less sensitivity, which means it can't able to find all the positive cases in one shot. Even though this can be used as a shortest and rapid method to find the corona cases in most of the person. That's why our Department of Science and Technology, they are funding these two different company. First one is FastSense, second one is Module Innovation. And apart from that, one more article is also talking about the similar thing, that having an heading saying that expert group meets vaccine makers. As per our previous report of government and also the wording which has been quoted by our Solicitor Attorney General Tushar Mehta in yesterday's Supreme Court hearing with related to postponement of JEE and NEET, they said, as per government report, they said that by August 15, we will launch COVID vaccine which has been developed by Bharat Biotech, that is Covaxin, will be launched before August 15, but we are even now in phase 2. We need to move on to phase 3, then alone we can able to launch the particular Covaxin tablet, Covaxin medicine in a market, so that that particular vaccine can able to cut short the spread of corona throughout the country. Here, this national expert group on COVID vaccine administration met some leading companies. First one is Serum Institute of India, second one is Bharat Biotech, and third one is Zydus Cadila, Genova Pharmaceuticals, and Biologically. These four companies met together to find the solution to accelerate this particular phase 1 and phase 2 to find the solution in terms of preparing a vaccination for controlling corona. As per the report, this corona can be completely curtailed only by prompt isolation and tracking the persons and timely clinical management. If we are doing this till we finding the vaccination, till we bringing the vaccination in the market, we need to follow these three steps. Otherwise, this corona will be increased. The rate of fatality, fatality rate, that is death rate or positive rate, will be keep on increasing. To curtail that, we need to follow these three methods. First one is prompt isolation, second one is tracking, third one is timely clinical management. And apart from that, till now, as per Health Ministry report, they have conducted tests for 3 crore people. But our total Indian population is more than 130 crore. If we need to detect this kind of test, our diagnostics lab network and facilitation should be increased. Presently, we are doing 7.3 lakhs per day, that is for 24 hours. If we are attaining a target saying that at least if we are doing test for 10 lakh people per day by producing antigen kit or RT-PCR kit, then we can easily detect corona spread within some particular time, so that till this particular innovation with respect to Covaxin or COVID vaccination comes into picture, we can able to reduce or curtail the fatality rate and positive rates of corona. And apart from that, it is maintained that early identification of cases has helped to ensure timely and prompt isolation of mild and moderate cases. But with respect to the critical and severe cases, effective management is required. For that, we were in sort of ventilators. Now it has been mostly sorted out. Now the problem in some tier 2 and tier 3 cities is patients are not getting sufficient number of beds. That too has been properly taken care by government. And our healthcare minister Harshavardhan, when he talked in an inaugural session with CII public healthcare conference on Monday, he said that the pandemic had given a chance to India to structurally reimagine the robust public healthcare infrastructure. Now we are working for it. For example, simply to say that before we are knowing about corona, most of the persons were not taking medical insurance. Now we are taking medical insurance. Medical insurance is taken by most of the citizens of India after getting the awareness about corona is only to cut short the medical expenditure. Simultaneously it is educating Indian masses in terms of getting related towards this corona vaccine and other things, other lively skills. And through Ayushman Bharat, government is serving the people effectively. There are several supply side concerns that need to be addressed. This is the main point which is being given by our Niti Aayog member Vinod Pal, that needs to be taken care, otherwise we can't able to bring an end to this corona. this is an end of this particular article. And there is one article which is related to Indo-Nepalese diplomatic discussion which was happened on yesterday, where they discuss about Kalapani territorial dispute, but they are not discussing about that cartographic map which is being developed by Nepalese government. The officials reviewed the status of construction of bridges over Mahakali River, which is near to the disputed region, but they have not talked about that cartographic, that is related to the new map with Indian territory. And both sides agreed and they emphasized about the need for expeditious implementation of bilateral projects to have a peaceful relation between these two countries. And both the foreign secretaries, they discussed about cross-border railways between India and Nepal, and Arundhri Hydra Power Project on Mahakali River, and Pancheshwara multi-purpose project with respect to irrigation, and construction of Nepal Police Academy. Presently, Nepal Police are being trained in Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel Police Training Academy, but Nepal is planning to develop new police training academy for Nepali separately. Apart from that, they also talked about Ramayana project. And this is an end of today's news analysis of Hindu. Thanks for listening. IIBS IAS Academy's current affairs channel, IIBS IAS News Bureau.